Speaker of Parliament Anita Among made her way to Mulago Hospital at around 10:30 a.m. to check on the ailing Dakabela County legislator, Cosmas Elotu, who is receiving treatment in the intensive care unit after surviving a nasty accident recently. She was received by the hospital management, led by the acting executive director, Dr. Rosemary Vianyima.
To visit one of the members of parliament, Honorable Elotu, who got an accident and is in ICU, but his condition is stable. He's actually recovering. I want to thank the management of Mulago. First, when I entered, I expected something different, but I was very impressed when I entered. The place is neat, it's well taken care of.
The speaker inspected operations in the intensive care unit and commended the hospital management for commendable services rendered to the public. However, she registered concerns of the shortage of staff to operate intensive care unit machines, yet the government has invested much in the machines that lie idle.
Disappointing is we have a very functional ICU, but we don't have human resource. We have an ICU of 29 beds, but only 14 are operational. I'm going to urge my colleagues, in this financial year, we should be able to increase the money for health for all the ICUs to be operational. We will support you.
Among committed on behalf of Parliament to support Mulago Hospital by enhancing its budget with effect from the next financial year. She emphasized a need to renovate facilities in the private wing of Mulago ahead of two international conferences to be hosted in Uganda next year, including the G77 Summit and the Non-Aligned Movement Summit, NAM.
Whatever it takes to make sure that the place is operational. And since we are even hosting visitors in December, the whole of next year, we'll make sure that we will also support as Parliament to renovate some private wings.
From the intensive care unit, the speaker went on to inspect operations in other wards like dialysis, organ transplant unit, and was impressed with the quality of care. Dr. Vianyima acknowledged challenges of understaffing, inadequate staff houses, and inadequate budget for supplies, which challenge service delivery.
So appreciated some of the challenges like the understaffing, which is stopping us from utilizing fully our ICU, the infrastructure for housing our staff, which is incomplete, that needs to be completed, and also an increase in budget of supplies which we require so that we can attend to our patients without asking them to chip in to buy one or two things.
She urged government to facilitate Mulago to get a stable power supply, especially in the intensive care unit wards. Vianyima says the three automatic generators which government bought for Mulago are not enough to solve power fluctuations.
Are on a priority line for electricity, but of course sometimes there are outages. Government of Uganda bought for us three big generators which automatically switched on when there's power outage, and they are serviced. We get a budget for that and we fuel them. But of course, power fluctuations can damage equipment, so we need really stable power. And with stable power, then our machines are stable.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.